What's up, YouTubers? It's Keith here making another video for you guys and for myself. It's going to kind of be short today because I'm limited on time, but I'm back working 6 days instead of five. Anyways, I want to first off say thank you to all you guys who subscribed, gave me thumbs up, positive feedback, even those who gave me thumbs down, whatever, them, you know, I don't wear my heart on my sleeve, but I want to thank you guys for the friend invites and all that jazz, meeting a lot of really cool people and smart people. First off and foremost, I want to share something, a text message. You know how you guys get text messages, they're like forward messages, you know, people get them and they forward to different people, and I usually don't pay attention to them, you know, I really don't, kind of like, you know, whatever. But a buddy of mine sent me one today that was really, it was really cool, and I want to share it with you guys because it's a really cool message in it. I don't know where it came from or whose original message it was, but I'm gonna read it to you guys, okay? It says, "A real man is a kind of man that when your feet hit the floor each morning, the devil says, oh crap, he's up. Brother, life is too short to wake up with regrets. So love the people who treat you right. Forgive the ones who don't just because you can. Believe everything happens for a reason. If you get a second chance, grab it with both hands. If it changes your life, let it. Take a few minutes to think before you act when you're mad. Forgive quickly. God never said life would be easy. He just promised it would be worth it. Today is Brother's Day. Send this to all your brothers, fathers, and sons. If you get back seven, you are, you know, all that stuff." And then it goes on to say, "Happy Brother's Day. I love you, brother. To the cool men that have touched my life, here's to you. A real brother walks with you when the rest of the world walks on you." So I wanted to share that to you guys because that was really nice and thoughtful, and it was a really cool message. You know, there's a lot of truthfulness to that, and I appreciate that, and I'll share it with, you know, whoever I can. And everything in all my videos, what I do, I share not because it's what I have, it's my own words. Some of it is, but for the majority of it, it's from what I've learned from other people. And, you know, I continue that by sharing with other people and you guys. So, you know, knowledge is key, you guys. And if we could all share useful, positive, uplifting, you know, inspiration, things that are of positive nature, we can all benefit from that. So I wanted to share that with you guys because I, you know, maybe it'll hit home with one of you guys or gals or whatever. Anyhow, I want to show you guys something. Now, I don't have any high-speed mirroring program, so I'm going to take my camera and show you guys this article that was posted and came out, I think it came out on the 10th. But I want to share it with you guys because it touches on what I spoke about in my last video regarding spirits, demons, and hypnosis, and all that jazz. So just hold on a minute, let me regroup, and I'll give you this heads up display. So hold on. All right, you guys, this is an article that I came across. It's from mlive.com, but it's covered by a bunch of different news agencies and whatnot. But the title is "Hypnosis Principle Faces Questions After Suicides." Okay, now if you guys have heard this, you'll be familiar with the story. If you haven't, look it up, you guys. It's a pretty good, quick little read. But I'm not gonna read the whole article because that's just lame. You guys can do that yourself if you're that interested. But I want to touch on it and then give you my thoughts and two cents afterwards. But it goes on about describing this cat, and he's a principal of the school. He's 51 years old. He's but the thing is that he practiced hypnosis on two students before their separate suicides this spring. Now, there's no indication that their deaths were any more than a tragic coincidence. However, Kennedy acknowledged conducting the sessions after being warned by his boss to stop such one-on-one hypnosis with students at school. Now, his boss told him, "You better knock that shit off."
Why would he do that if it was something that was beneficial for the students? Well, maybe these reporters or whatever should ask his boss. Why? But regardless of the fact of the matter, this happened in Northport, Florida. If you guys are familiar where that is, or maybe you're out there, but it doesn't really matter. It's a story that's more, you know, is interesting. Anyways, when they asked, now the administrator situation then got stickier when an investigator showed that he had also hypnotized another student 5 months before her May 4th suicide, initially lied about it, and had defied 3 separate verbal warnings to stop the sessions with students. This cat, who is a principal, so he's not some little, just a regular teacher. He's a principal of a school, and his school district told him, look, stop doing that. Now, granted, he would get permission from the student's parents because you have to do that. So he got the parental go-ahead and green light permission so that they can practice his hypnosis therapy on his students because they needed help with sports or academics. The main part was say that they had to focus on a test. Well, in April, according to the Sarasota County District School District report, he hypnotized a 16-year-old student, 16 years old. Now, I mean, when I was 16, yeah, it was rough, but I would never say it was so rough that I had to be hypnotized for it, or, you know, whatever the problems were. But, you know, today's school is a lot harder than what we went to school, but that's a fact. But anyways, the next day, the boy committed suicide, and Kennedy was put on leave in May when the boy's parents, who gave their permission for the sessions, raised concerns after his death. Now, you ever heard of that parental feeling? A parent knows? Parental just intuition? Parents have that. I have that. I'm a father of 3, and I'm sure you parents or your parents had a parental instinct when something is not right or questionable. And they did after their son's suicide. I mean, they know their son, they know their child. And when, you know, all of a sudden they commit suicide out of the blue, it kind of raises a question. Read the full article, you guys. You can just Google it and read more upon this. But it's just what boggles my mind is he lied about it. If he wasn't doing anything wrong, why would he lie? It says initially he lied about it and defied 3 separate verbal warnings. So he was instructed to stop and he didn't. And then he lied about that. He even conducted the hypnosis ceremony or session. So, I mean, that alone, it's like, well, what the hell? You know, it's like the whole Anthony, the Casey Anthony case. You know, she lied to the investigators. She lied. If you have nothing to hide, you shouldn't have nothing to lie about. Regardless, whatever you feel, that's the truth. If you lie, boy, you're just, you know, and the truth will come out eventually. But this is something, you know, like, what the hell? Why is he lying? Anyway, of course, his colleagues give him praise and say he's the glue that holds the school together, and said his administrative assistants, of course she's going to say that. She's not going to say anything else bad about him, but, you know, whatever. Read the full article, you guys, but I want to read this quote from this guy, Zimmerman, which I think is, Kennedy declined to comment through his attorney, Mark Zimmerman, who said there is no causal connection between the hypnosis sessions and their suicides. Well, yeah, okay, he's his attorney. But this is what Zimmerman says. It sort of conjures up a feeling of mind control, which of course is not what hypnosis is, Zimmerman said. This was hypnosis as a relaxation and focus technique to aid in tests and athletic performance. Okay? That's what that says. Go on and read all this other stuff, and then it says how Dr. Kennedy isn't doing any hocus pocus. Well, why would that word hocus pocus? See, when you bring up words like hocus pocus or anything like that, you're already, you know, you're making an assumption of something, you know, whatever. But anyways, it goes on to talk about his credentials and how he's a a part of a committee, and he got his certification from hypnosis school or all that jazz. But this is a crazy article. If you guys read it, it's really crazy. Here, let me read you this last one right here. It says, Gerald Kane, a director of the National Board of Hypnosis Education and Certification, described hypnosis as bypassing the critical factor of the conscious mind, creating an open-mindedness to new ideas. You guys got to check this out. But isn't it funny? Not funny. It's very tragic that these kids committed suicide and deemed that as the only way out of their situation. It's very tragic, and it's very sad for the families of those people, of those young kids, man. But read this article, and I just made a video. My last video was covering about hypnosis and how it delves into this. It opens these channels of accepting like new ideas, and you know, really, you have no control. The person undergoing the hypnosis has no control. But look at this article, you guys. You can Google it. Just type in "principal in trouble for hypnosis" or whatever you want to do. But this happened July 10th. And it's a pretty crazy read. So I'm going to pause this and get back to the face-to-face. All right, you guys. So there you go. I brought you guys an article so that you guys can read it and check it out for yourself. The reason why I wanted to bring it to your guys' attention is this. It's coincidental that I just talked about in my last video about the power of that hypnosis has and what it could unlock. Now, where hypnosis originated from, do your research just on that, okay? Hypnosis originated from seances and rituals and possessions. I mean, you don't have to believe me. Look it up yourself so you could find out the origins of hypnosis. And now it's becoming accepted in therapy. But even to extend it even more, it's happening in our schools, in our public schools. Now, this cat was told by his district to stop it, knock it off. Now, if it was such a good means and method of helping out the students, everybody would do it, or everybody would be acceptable to the idea. But the fact is that this guy did this, and he was deliberately told to stop doing it. One of the kids had her parent there for the session, and he urged the parents to be there. But the other students, hey, their parents weren't there. Nobody was there. Who knows what the hell happened in that session? I guarantee you the student that was hypnotized doesn't. So, you know, that's the whole purpose of my debate, is that hypnosis is freaking dangerous, you guys. It's dangerous because it, in quotations, it says it opens the mind to new ideas, and you know, you could program, and it's mind control. Hypnosis has worked in television. In our television today, in our TV programs, it's all hypnosis through means of, if you look at, go and do your research, because there's a form of therapy that you can use that put it this way, let me describe it in a very small kind of picture, illustration. When a woman's pregnant and she has a baby, or twins, or whatever, when she's carrying a baby, they suggest that you play you can buy them, of course you have to buy them, they're audio cassettes and CDs of music, and you can put headphones on your stomach or play it in the background, but it's music that's of relaxation. And what it does is it has a certain RPMs, beats per minute. It has a certain amount of beats per minute that subliminally soothes the mind, and it works with small infants. It soothes them and calms them and helps them relax and go to sleep when they're fussing or rolling around in the womb. Now, when the baby's born, of course, they even have it after. You can play melodies, you know, and for relaxation.
Well, in pop music today, all the beats are roughly around 72 beats per minute to 75 beats per minute. Now, those beats per minute have an effect on your mind, on your subconscious mind, just like colors do. I mean, you can go online and go look at all these illusions and these trick pictures, and it's an illusion, but it's through means of colors or lines or music or TV programs. But that's just an example of how these methods can use to subliminally enhance certain levels of activity in your brain unconsciously to the person and unaware. But what hypnosis does is you're voluntarily allowing yourself to be completely vulnerable to anything that's suggested to you. And so that's why I'm saying hypnosis is very dangerous, okay? What its origins come from is, rituals, and stuff like that. And you open a channel. You open a channel that, if anything's out in the immediate area that wants to get involved, you're opening up to that. But if you go look at the movie, it's called The Fourth Kind. That's what it's called. But if you look at that movie, look at that movie. It has to deal with hypnosis, the therapist, and suicides right after the sessions, alien abduction, demonic possession. And you know what? Just do your research, you guys. But I wanted to bring that to your attention because it was coincidental, because last video I was talking about that. That's pretty much it, you guys. There's a lot of stuff. There's a lot of news out here that's going on right now. It's a pretty crazy summer, and it's not done yet. So keep the positive energy up, you guys. Again, thank you to all subscribers. I'm cutting this short. I'm getting a lot of good questions from you guys. A lot of good ideas and a lot of good points that you guys are making. Keep it up. A lot of people are sending me a bunch of crap too, but I don't wear my heart on my sleeve talking crap about my tattoos. Look, I'm not hiding behind a camera, you guys. I'm talking face to face. And if you're intimidated by my tattoos, if your level of intelligence is that low to where you are judgmental on looks and appearances, then look away. Don't go into my channel. Don't do anything like that. Once you see my tattoos and you're like turned off by it, well then turn away. I'm not here to offend anybody, but at the same time, I have the right to have tattoos just like you have the right not to have tattoos. So don't come bitching or talking crap on my page about my tattoos. This one cat up there, and I gave him the benefit of the doubt before I finally had to block him because he was just being disrespectful, and I gave him a chance to talk to me like an adult, and if he wants to debate about anything, I there's colleges all the time, and there's debates all the time in colleges, and you can't get mad, you have to respect the other person's opposition, but at the same time you have to listen, and it has to be an intellectual exchange, because no one, not everyone's going to agree with me. There's probably 1,000 people or whoever, and however amount of number of people that are watching this video right now that are saying, I totally disagree with that guy. And that's completely fine, you guys. I'm not expecting you to agree with me on everything I say. Like I say, these videos are my opinions and views on the research that I've done or the studies that I've found. That's why I always encourage you guys to do it yourself. But this cat comes on here and he's talking crap. He says that something about the serpent on my neck, and that's what I am, a serpent. You guys, really? Like, wow. Like, that's what you have to say? First of all, like I replied to him, I said, I don't know what's worse, your idea of what a serpent is or your vision, because I don't have any serpents on my neck. I don't have one tattoo of a serpent. Let me go over my tattoo, just on my neck, you guys. What this is a sacred heart. Okay, if you find that evil or dark and blah, 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 go Google that shit. Sacred heart. Okay, this is a sacred heart on my neck. Okay? And I'm not going to go into the representations because you guys can do that. This on my on this side, on this side name, my neck, is a Irish clottery. It's our, me and my wife's red and green. Yes, I am Irish. Not all 100%, but I do have Irish in me. But that's me and my wife's wedding ring. And she has the same tattoo. Not on her neck, but she has the same tattoo on her arm. And what it is it's a claw. It's an Irish wedding band. It's an Irish clod ring. It has hands holding a heart with a crown. And it stands for friendship, love, and loyalty, and honor. That's what this stands for. And it, on the band, it says taken. So that's my wedding ring. I'm like I said before, I'm a welder, and I've gone through wedding rings, you guys. But I don't wear wedding. I don't wear a wedding ring. But I have it tatted on my neck. Okay, and it says take it on the back. So that's what this is. So for that jackass out there that wants to judge me and say I have trash and I defiled my body, this guy made this comment on the video I made about my Tarot 03 rant. Now first off, Tarot 03 has never made a video showing what he looks like on YouTube or the internet alone. There's no pictures of him. So all these followers that he has don't have no idea of what this guy looks like. He could be covered to head and toe in tattoos. And this guy's judging me because of my tattoos? Oh, dude, don't worry. I'm not going to get mad, okay? You're not going to get that from me. But I'm addressing it because there may be some viewers that don't know what my tattoos are. This is a Sacred Heart. This is an Irish clottery. That's what's on my neck. So if it offends you, I'm sorry. I'm not trying to offend anybody with my tattoos. But I don't have to go into that, you guys. Today's times are a hell of a lot different. And I've had tattoos for years. I'm covered with tattoos from my neck to my knuckles. You know what I mean? So I'm not trying to be offensive or anything like that. And if you guys are offended by my tattoos, I'm sorry. Then you don't have to watch my videos. Or listen to what I say. And I told this guy, oh, I'm not going to fall. I don't trust you. Oh, well, you know what? Okay, that's fine. You know, I promise you I won't lose any sleep over it. Okay? But anyways, I just wanted to address that because of my tattoos. There was another article I don't read the news because I like to pay attention to alternative media resources. But when my homepage is Yahoo. And so when I go on there, they have all the streaming articles of that day or whatever. But it had this story of success, something like that, 10 ways to be successful. Now, this was just a couple days ago. Now, I want to address that because real briefly, real quick, success is measured on a personal opinion. It's just a personal opinion. Okay, now bear with me, stay with me, you guys. Just like everything in this world and in this universe is based on opinions. I mean, everything. Everything you were taught, everything is based on opinions. Whether it's from people of really well-educated backgrounds or whether it's not. And success is an opinion deemed by a society. Now, what do you might ask, what exactly do I mean? I'll give you an example. There could be someone who's extremely successful and extremely wealthy and has a huge bank account and doesn't have to worry about financial problems and burdens. And people look at him and say, or her, and say, wow, that is a successful individual. Okay? But what you fail to realize, because you don't know the person in depth and personally, they can have a crappy relationship with their wife. Crappy. Completely crappy. Or their children. Treat their children like shit. Okay? So, is that success? Is that a successful person? Now, we all have our downfalls and our own problems. But someone who is rich and powerful can be successful in one aspect. But that person can look at another family, that another father or mother that has a beautiful relationship with their child and doesn't have $10 in their bank account. And that person of wealth and power can look at that person and say, wow, that person is successful. So success is measured at a personal perspective. It's just of what other people perceive and deem as success. But, you know, it's such a race for people trying to be successful. They just, you know, their idea of success, they're so wrapped up in the idea of success, being successful, that they're losing themselves of their personal values and morals and traits that mean more success. You know, when Jesus Christ, I'm gonna talk to you guys, if you believe in Christianity or if you believe in any other religion, you've heard of Jesus Christ. I'm assuming everybody out there has heard of Jesus Christ. Whether you follow him or not, just listen to me. We all know, and we all believe from what we were taught, that Jesus Christ was born a son of a carpenter. Okay? He wasn't born of someone of wealth. He wasn't born from a king. I mean, he came from, you know, but he wasn't born by a man that was a king or a ruler. He was born, and he was a humble person, and he was born, you know, in a rural area. He wasn't born in some well-established shrine. He was born in a stable, you know. So, success. The reason why I'm saying is success doesn't mean shit. It doesn't mean anything, you guys. It's a facade. It's a made-up thing for people it's an illusion. Success is a complete and total illusion. Can you have wealth and have good relationships and be successful? Yes. Yes, you can. I'm not saying that you can't. But I'm saying the success, as far as what society deems as being successful, is a bunch of crap. It's an illusion. Because look at Jesus Christ. He wasn't born of extreme wealth, but everybody in the world that I know, or the majority of people in the world, has heard of Jesus Christ. Was it because he inherited all this land and materialistic crap that people today, in today's society, deem as success? Did he conquer great nations in his short time of life? No. But he was the greatest man who ever lived. He was the greatest man who ever lived on this earth. Everybody knows that. So why aren't people following his example? Why aren't people viewing his life as success? Because people have lost their way of thought and belief. Who do you think's behind the other side that thinks, no, don't follow that guy. That's not successful. That's the only way of success you can get, people. Trying to follow and his example that he led, Jesus Christ. He was a good person. I can't. The most successful person in the world is Jesus Christ. In my world. In your reality, you may have some other idea. And that's fine. But it's just something to think about. Food for thought, if you will. You know, he wasn't born of wealth. He wasn't born of power in this earth. You know, like they asked him, where's your kingdom? You say you're a king. King of kings. Where's your kingdom? He says, my kingdom's not of this world, man. My kingdom's up there. And it's greater than any kingdom here on this little rock. So think about that, you guys. Think about the success that he did, that has perpetuated to our time right now. How many followers he has. Think about that. That is success. Follow by his example, you guys. Try and live a humble life and be a good person. What's the worst that can happen? Really, what's the worst that can happen? You worry about success and taking all these business adventures and all that. There's a lot of bad things that can happen. A lot. It's a gamble. And it's hard being successful in a materialistic world. And it's also hard to be successful on the spiritual side of it. Because you're going to get opposition. Greater opposition than you would trying to be successful in the materialistic realm in the world. Like, you know, my mother, she's going through a hard time right now. I'm not going to go into that, you guys, but... And I told her, look, Mom, you know, we're at a time right now where it's a spiritual warfare. You know, there's good... It's a spiritual warfare going on. I mean, this is crunch time. You're going to get opposition. If you don't face opposition for what you're doing, then you might not be doing something right. But if you are facing opposition and you're just trying to live a good life, a good person, you know, you have your belief system in your God, and it seems like the world's against you, you're doing something right. You're doing something right. Let that be the motivation and drive to drive you on. I'm going to pause real quick, you guys. Hold on. All right, you guys, I'm back. But what I was saying was, I was telling my mother to be strong. You know, and I'm going to tell you guys, be strong, you guys. Be strong. It's so much easier to do the wrong thing. It's going to be a lot harder to do what's right. And so when we're facing these trials and tribulations on a personal level, just cowboy up and suck it up and realize that this is supposed to happen. Let it be the motivation to help you endure. That's all we have to do is endure it, man. Endure this ride to the end. You're going to face opposition. You know, Jesus Christ said, you know, when you feel that they hate you, know that they hated me first. They're going to persecute you, but know that they persecuted me first. Something like that. But basically what he's saying is, look, they're going to turn on my people. And that's what's going to happen. So keep your faith, you guys. Keep your faith. If you're not a Christian, if you have your own belief system, who am I to tell you to believe in this or believe in that? If that's what you were raised in and you feel it in your spiritual self, in your soul, that is your religious factor, then that is your religious belief, then be true to it. That's all I'm saying. Be true to it. Don't be hypocritical. Be true to it. But if you find yourself questioning your faith, then maybe your faith in that isn't, you know what I'm saying? If you're always curious of maybe that's not it, you know, there's nothing wrong with having feelings. We're human beings. But what I'm saying is don't give up your faith. Don't give up your faith. Be true to it and real. Me, personally, I have my beliefs and how I feel about it. But I'm not going to sit here and try to force my ideas and thoughts on anyone. I'm going to share them. But I encourage you guys to do all your own studies and all your own research. That doesn't stop at religion. That doesn't stop at spiritual belief. But be cautious, because like I said before, there's lots of false religions out there. And they will be exposed. They will be exposed. You know. But that's my idea, and that's my feelings, and that's my beliefs, you guys. Take it or leave it, I'm just speaking. Okay, I'm speaking to you guys. And getting what I feel out there. But, you know, is it going to get hard? Hell yeah. Is it going to be easier to take the easier route? Hell yeah. It's going to be hard. This is going to be a hard ride, you guys. But buck up and hang and stick it through to the end. What is the worst that can happen? What, you lose your life? I don't know. Are you scared of losing your life? Everybody should be scared of dying. I mean, not scared of dying, but you don't want to leave, like, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to leave my family alone without me. That's what I would worry about. But the actual idea of death, if you have a hope, if you have a hope for something greater than what this is, then you won't be fearful. Don't be fearful. Don't have fear. Don't give in to fear, you guys. I mean, being scared is a natural feeling. You know, you're going to be scared. It's going to be scary. It's going to be hard. But stick to your guns. Stick to your guns. You know, stick to your, you know, your belief system. Ride it out to the end. All right, you guys, I'm gonna let this go, but you know, thanks for all the subscriptions or subscribers, you guys. I made a lot of good friends. I'm gonna make another video. I didn't have a whole lot to cover today because I'm kind of crunched for time. I know this video is kind of long now, but I had a long day, man. I washed my car, my truck. I washed my motorcycle. I washed my dog. So I was outside in the heat. So I was kind of like, you know, California heat. But I love you guys. Keep your energy up. Stay positive. Be maximum for love. And just stick with me, you guys. Stick with me. All right? If you guys have subscribed to me, I appreciate it. If I can help you out, I will. I'll make more videos on survival tips and stuff like that. I've got a lot of PM requests. So I will make more videos, you guys, when I get the time. But all right, you guys, take care. And remember, it doesn't matter what happens around you, but what matters is what happens within you. Remember that, and you'll be golden. All right, love you guys. Take care.